Hi guys, Leslie's back with another video. This time she's showing you how to solve tree diagrams.
Okay, we're going to look at tree diagrams today. We're going to start with the very simple basic tree diagrams where you can use them as a tool to solve probability questions. People do tend to be frightened of probability, but when you have a method to help you solve questions, they really are quite formulaic and you should quite enjoy doing them. So we have this question. Dan and Charlie are playing a game of chess. For each game, the probability that Dan wins is 0.4 and the probability that Charlie wins is 0.6, and they play two games. Now, this is the important thing about tree diagrams. They're actually going to play two games. So it's the fact that two different things are happening. So we're going to have two lots of branches for our tree. The first branches will be what happens on the first game, and the second branches will be what happens on the second game. Now, if you look at the information you are given, there's only two possibilities in this game. One of them has got to win. Either Dan will win or Charlie will win. They're not considering the chance that there's going to be a draw, so ignore that. So we have only got two different outcomes. So on our first branches of our tree, we just have two different options. We can either have Dan winning the game, or we can have Charlie winning the game. So if you look at how I've set it out, the two branches, at the end of each branch, I've written down the two different outcomes. The probability that Dan will win is 0.4, and the probability that Charlie will win is 0.6. And if you add 0.4 and 0.6 together, they give you the value 1. Now, this is crucial. On these branches, the branches must always add up to 1, because something has got to happen, and 1 is a definite probability. So 0.4 that Dan will win, 0.6 that Charlie will win. They're the only two possible outcomes, and 0.4 plus 0.6 gives you 1. That's the first game. Now, no matter what happens in the first game, you've then got to think about the second game. So coming along here, if Dan wins, they will play a second game, and effectively they're starting from scratch again. So in the second game, we have two options, Dan can win or Charlie can win. The probabilities haven't changed, so the chance of Dan winning is 0.4 and the chance of Charlie winning is 0.6. Now, completely separately, if we go back right to the very beginning here, it might have been that when they played the first game, Charlie won, and they would then play a second game. In this second game, Dan could win or Charlie could win. And again, the probabilities won't have changed. It's still 0.4 for Dan and 0.6 for Charlie. So if you look, each time I draw some branches, the probabilities add up to 1. 0.4 plus 0.6 is 1. And then completely separately, on this set of branches, 0.4 plus 0.6 is 1. Okay. Then list the different outcomes. Even if the question doesn't ask you to do it, it is worth listing this because it helps you answer any questions they set at the end of the question. List the outcomes. So if you follow along here, that is Dan winning, and then they play a second game, and that again is Dan winning. So the outcome would be that Dan wins both games. Go back to the very beginning. The other alternative is that Dan might win the first game, but Charlie might win the second game. And in this case, the outcome would be Dan, Charlie. Go back to the beginning again. Completely different set of outcomes would be if Charlie won the first game and then Dan won the second game. So that would be Charlie, Dan. And the last thing possible, Charlie wins that game and Charlie wins the second game. So that would be Charlie. Okay, now associated with all these different outcomes, there will be a set of probabilities. To work out the probabilities, you multiply along the branches. So the probability that Dan wins both games is 0.4 from there, multiplied by 0.4 from there. So it's 0.4 multiplied by 0.4, which is 0.16. The second chance was that Dan won the first game, but Charlie won the second game. So it's 0.4 times 0.6, which is 0.24. The third option is that Charlie wins the first game and Dan wins the second game. So it's 0.6 times 0.4, which again is 0.24. And the last option, Charlie wins the first game, Charlie wins the second game. So it's 0.6 times 0.6, which is 0.36. Now, another crucial check is if you add these numbers together, 0.16 plus 0.24 plus 0.24 plus 0.36, you should always get the total 1, because one of these four things is absolutely bound to happen. Now, with all this set up in front of you, you can then answer anything the question then sets. So in this case, it wants you to work out the probability that Dan wins both games. Because you've listed the outcomes, it's very, very easy to see that where Dan wins both games is the outcome Dan, and the probability associated with that is 0.16. So you can immediately write down your answer. It's 0.16. The second part, Charlie wins exactly one game. Again, if you look at the listings, the places where Charlie wins one game is where Dan wins the first and Charlie wins the second, or Charlie wins the first and Dan wins the second. In each case, Charlie's won one game. Look at the probabilities you've worked out. That's 0.24, that's 0.24, and here you add the two probabilities together. So the chance of Charlie winning just one game is 0.48. So answering the questions at the end is very, very easy because you have all the information there in front of you. Let's do an example of a tree diagram, the basic tree diagram through from scratch. The probability that Lennon beats Gary at tennis is 2/3. They play 2 matches. Again, the 2 matches is the crucial thing. That tells us that the first thing we're going to look at is the first match, and next to that we're going to consider the second match. So in the first match, there's only 2 things that can happen. Gary can win or Lennon can win. Remember the different wording. Lennon winning means Gary loses, so you can say Gary wins and Gary loses, or you can say Gary wins, and alternatively, Lennon wins. Same sort of thing. So the probability that Lennon wins, and I'm just going to use L to abbreviate it a bit, the probability that Lennon beats Gary at tennis is 2/3. So the chance of Lennon winning is 2/3. The other alternative is that Gary might win, and remember these two numbers must add up to 1, so if the chance of Lennon winning is 2/3, the chance of Gary winning is 1/3. That's going to stay constant for the second match. So they play the first match. If Lennon wins, they play again. Match 2, Lennon might win or Gary might win. The chance hasn't changed, so the chance of Lennon winning is 2/3. And the chance of Gary winning is 1/3. Alternatively, right back to the beginning, they play the first match and Gary might win. If Gary wins the first match, they play again. In the second match, Lennon might win or Gary might win. Lennon might win with a chance of 2/3. Gary will win with a chance of 1/3. List the outcomes. It doesn't tell you to do this at the moment, it's just saying draw a tree diagram, but everything I'm doing here is part of the tree diagram and will help you answer the following questions. So the different outcomes, that's Lennon winning match one, Lennon winning match two. So that outcome is Lennon winning both matches. Back to the beginning, Lennon might win the first match and Gary the second match. So that outcome is Lennon winning one and Gary winning one. Back to the beginning again, this time Gary might win the first match and Lennon the second match, which means the outcome would be Gary followed by Lennon. And the last way is that Gary wins the first match and Gary wins the second match, where the outcome would be Gary followed by Gary. Work out the probability associated with all of these, and you multiply along the branches. So the chance of Lennon winning both matches is 2/3 multiplied by 2/3, which is 4/9. The chance of Lennon winning the first and Gary winning the second is 2/3 multiplied by 1/3, which is 2/9. The chance of Gary winning the first and Lennon winning the second is 1/3 multiplied by 2/3, which is again 2/9. And the chance of Gary winning the first and Gary winning the second is 1/3 times 1/3, which is 1/9. And as a check, if we add these together, 4/9 plus 2/9 plus 2/9 plus 1/9 is 9/9, which is 1. And these should add up to 1. Now we're all set up and the rest of the question is very easy. Lennon winning both matches. Look at your listing. Lennon winning both matches is here and the probability of that is 4/9. So the probability of Lennon winning both matches is 4/9. Lennon winning the first match and Gary winning the second match. Look down your list. There's Lennon winning the first and Gary winning the second, and the probability of that is 2/9. So there's my second answer. And the last question, Lennon wins just one match. Well, he can win just one match either here, where he wins the first and Gary wins the second, or here, where Gary wins the first and Lennon wins the second. Two different ways that can happen. So we add the two probabilities together. 2/9 plus 2/9 is 4/9. So those questions were very easy to answer if you set the tree diagram out in this complete way.